Chapter 4, Rising Fever. The Great Hunt. Alright, let's go to the docks and let's get started again. Hello? Are you okay, buddy? Got my trusty hatchet. Come here. I wanna get you. Resisted. I hate that. No resisted allowed. Resisted. What the fuck, man? Come here where I can get you. No. What is that bullshit? Nullified. Oh shit. What the hell is going on around here? You suck on that. Resisted? I don't believe in it. Stop it. Oh, you son of a bitch. Stop it. Resisted? Bullshit. Stop resisting. Take it. Yeah. Resisted, come on. No resisted. Oh my god. Yeah. Oh, what is that? It's not even doing shit. Come here. Finally. Ah. Dr. Strickland's list. Sodium hydrochlorite. It's a good one. Opium. Potassium.
Opium is one of the main ingredients of Strickland's medication. Never a good move.
And coffee. Investigation! Something. Alright. Alright, you can skip across right here. Hey, no burning me. Yeah, they're having a party over there. Oh. The fool. I'm trying to go to this lady's mansion.
You must prepare, child. For the earth is bleeding and the harvest is upon us.
Nom nom.
Stay away! Whoever you are!
I mean, stay away.
This is no time for petty quarrels, my champion. Can you not hear? The famished queen has awoken.
Tell her to go back to sleep. These are all stupid.
I am not your champion. Go away. I insist you be quiet.
I insist you be quiet!
Son, do you not see? You are the healing.
Be
bard.
Quiet!
Why not just
I
tell
had
him
to kill
shut up?
Mary!
I have known your pain, child. Do not succumb to it.
No, shut up! I told
silence.
You! Shut up!
I dismiss you!
Silence!
Now.
The land.
You insolent pleb!
All and everyone needs you.
Now shut up! Silence!
Silence!
Yeah, silence! Yeah, go away!
I'm tired of all these.
I'm not
shows.
Your champion!
We're getting closer.
Lady? What are y'all doing out here?
Twitching out like you live in Washington. St. California. I guess this is London tweakers. Out of stamina. Yeah, just keep blocking, buddy. I'm gonna charge up. No grabby. Trying to grab my cheeks. Anything in there? Allison. Don't know what that's for. Go to Lady Ashbury's mansion. Where it is. I'll break through here. Yeah. Some dead people. Oh, I see some tweakers. Hey, you bunch of tweakers. Oh, shit. This one's got a sword. Vampyr. Wanna fight? He's outta here. Alright, gas fart thrower over here. I don't know why they didn't just make them all flamethrowers. Like, why is this one a fart thrower? What is that shit? Why are you gassing me? They're like, flamethrower, that's boring. We need a fart thrower too. You'll never know if it's a fart thrower or a flamethrower. Because they look the same. Same fucking character. Missed opportunity. Y'all could have made him have like a taxi. Like a taxi outfit. You know a taxi? Taxi? Hey, taxi! I'm gonna bite your ass! No. Stop farting. Stop bitch slapping me. What the hell? I'm standing over here. God. Jank. Why you jank me? Stop janking me off game. What else we got? Nope, can't go in there. Can't see nobody in there. I heard a cough. Lady Ashbury.
So this is where she lives.
I'm coming to see you. Should have brought my radio, my boombox.
Dr. Reed, welcome.
Hello.
As good as one can
Hello,
be,
lovely.
The circumstances.
Yes. Death and affliction seem prevailing themes of late. Please, come in.
Don't mind if I do, my lass. So this is where we live, is it?
I hope I haven't disturbed you.
Not at all. Actually, I was counting on you visiting me tonight.
Oh yeah, you were, girl.
How
I brought condoms.
Strange, this painting. Beautiful, melancholic, yet with a haunting dignity.
Indeed.
And
a
coffee.
Long time ago, a friend asked me to paint this for him.
Would you like some coffee?
But I kept it in the end.
I did not know you were a painter, my lady.
There are many things you do not know
you're
about
such
me,
an artiste.
Young Econ.
Like your body count.
Call me Jonathan.
Please excuse my
behavior,
Jonathan.
The lady.
I tend to tease my friends.
Lady Elizabeth.
What is bothering you, my lady?
Oh, you're nervous,
your
lady?
Your letter was quite alarming.
We will talk about this in a few minutes. For now, I would like you to tell me about yourself.
Okay.
How have you been since we last met, my friend?
Wonderful. I'm so powerful now. I'm kicking everyone's ass. I got a hatchet.
I came to the conclusion that my maker, whoever he might be,
thinking about getting a liger,
powerful vampire,
and a bow staff.
Certainly extremely old.
How have you reached this conclusion?
I felt his power.
Radiated
the power of the dark side.
Most ancestral vampires of England were killed by the Guard of Priwen half a century ago.
Most of
them. I wonder who your maker could be.
You have no idea who he could be?
Some of the ancient ones fled England. Some may still be in hiding. All I know is you, my friend, are a pawn in some secret and obscure game of chess.
I mean, it's not super flattering, but it is what it is.
He's the only immortal I've seen appear in an ethereal form. His voice, his words seemed ancient. It was disturbing.
I am afraid you are right. The simple fact that your blood made Mary such a strong Ekon proves that you must be of ancient lineage.
Oh, yeah. I'm a bad motherfucker.
My sister Mary. She was made a vampire in the same way I was. She was the one killing all those people everywhere I went.
Vengeance is a powerful force for those betrayed. Made vampire through careless error. Victims by surprise.
Oh no.
I killed Mary twice.
In the end, she implored me to put an end to her misery. But still, I felt I had taken her life twice.
I am so sorry for my accidental cruelty. Had I known your dear Mary was still alive, I would never have sent you to pray for her soul in that church.
Yeah,
there is
like
no need to apologize,
lady.
My lady. Your words have been most helpful in these difficult times.
Thank you,
my
friend.
No, you fucked up. We need to hold you accountable.
If only we could have guided your poor sister.
That was a poor decision on your part.
I think I should ask the questions, your ladyship. After all, it was you who invited me to settle this most urgent of matters.
Fair enough, Jonathan. The situation is critical. We do not have the luxury for etiquette.
Please do not misunderstand me. I would be delighted to discuss mundane matters and idle trivialities.
If we survive the dark nights to come,
we can have small chat and spoon.
We shall have more time in the world to speak, you and I. For now, please follow me, Jonathan.
Let the spooning begin.
I must say, your house is exquisite.
One of the advantages of living forever is having the time to be selective with one's furnishings. I took the liberty of having tea served.
You can still drink tea.
Can't keep it down, but I do so enjoy the aroma. Let us toast to make-believe. And of course, to your health, Jonathan.
And to yours, my lady.
I just like the smell of it. Ah, drinking tea. That's funny.
Please,
nice touch.
Call me Elizabeth.
So, my lady, why truly did you invite me here?
I've been asked to deliver an official invitation to meet the Ascalon Club.
Who are they? Really?
They are the embodiment of vampire lore in Britain. Some say they influence the destiny of the Empire. Some believe
the Empire
protected.
How many are they?
Only a small number of powerful and deceitful immortals. All of them entangled in a sticky web of shadow cabinets influencing trade.
Okay.
Will they fight the guard of Priwen?
I doubt it. Fergal was Lord Redgrave's executioner forever and a day. By defeating that beast, you deprived them of a powerful weapon.
Yeah, I did. I whooped that boy's ass. Whooped that ass. What do you want? Let's see.
Why use you to contact me?
Because they know we are close. The Ascalon Club has many spies. Their main occupation is gathering information and then deciding how to use it.
Have they threatened you in any way?
Not at all. Their message surprised me at first. But it is only logical, considering the critical situation in London.
Okay.
They have done nothing but impede my investigations since I became known to them. Why would they want to see me now?
I guess they now see you as Ascalon material. They must have found out what happened to your sister. Proof of the potent blood flowing through your veins.
I'm not sure I can accept their invitation. I have seen their handiwork. How Fergal the Beast imposed the club's law.
You have no choice, Jonathan. Even I would not openly defy Lord Redgrave, the chairman of the Ascalon Club.
Okay, well. Who's this mofo?
What can you tell me about Lord Redgrave? Who is he?
Lord Redgrave is the founder and chairman of the Ascalon Club. Most mortals know him as the Earl of Bristol. He is rich and extremely influential.
Have you met him before?
Only on rare occasions, for he never goes outside the club. And women are not awarded membership, even immortals.
Second-class citizens, eh?
How powerful is his reach?
The Ascalon Club may be the most influential secret society in England. Not all its members are immortals, but they are all very powerful.
Sounds important.
Any familiar or famous names?
As the richest, most relentless British tycoon, Aloysius Dawson is considered ideal Ascalon material and has been watched for years.
They are not all immortals. How is that?
The club is mainly comprised of political figures who seek the safety and expansion of the
Empire. Political figures, those are the worst.
The most loyal are awarded immortality.
None of them should be able to be vampires, but they all are.
If you are convinced I must meet him, I will heed your advice.
Thank you, Jonathan. I understand your reluctance to brush shoulders with London's vampire elite. But we have no choice.
Is the situation that critical?
Yes. The Guard of Priwen has called for a second great hunt of our kind. And they will stop at nothing to eliminate us.
What is a great hunt?
The first great hunt was launched about 75 years ago. In just a few nights, the Guard of Priwen located and destroyed most of the old British vampires.
Right.
How did you survive the first hunt?
I fled, Jonathan. Like most vampires who survived that slaughter. And I secretly came back when I was sure they had lost my trail.
Why start a second one?
Priwen has always seen us immortals as a threat to mankind. My guess is they suspect one or more of us is the cause of the epidemic.
It's you, bitch. It's you.
Will the Guard of Priwen and the Ascalon Club fight each other?
I doubt it. If Priwen really launched a great hunt, I think most of the Ekons I know would flee the country to escape the bloodbath.
I think I saw them kill an Ekon on the way to your house. They seem to have a list with names.
To launch another great hunt.
They it's a great hunt of the Jews.
Intelligence on vampire identities and whereabouts.
The vampires are the Jews. The bad guys are the good guys all of a sudden. What's going on around here? See, I knew I was a good vampire.
Should we fight back?
They're trying to Jew me
I
out.
I will not be hunted down like an animal again.
Not like a Jew.
I admire your courage, Jonathan. But the best way to fight them is to put an end to the epidemic. This is the only way to clear the air.
You should flee then. Leave London, the country even. I have seen the guard in action. They are merciless.
Your concern warms my heart, Jonathan. But fear not. If the situation gets too dangerous, I shall retreat to my secret Scottish manor. I could hide you in my luggage, if you wish.
Thank you for the offer. I shall keep it in mind, but I have much to do here. There is a question I must ask you. Could Lord Redgrave be my maker?
I doubt it. If Lord Redgrave had made you his progeny, he would not have seemed so surprised when you demonstrated the strength of your lineage.
Good point.
What is the plan?
The plan is we both try to save this city, you and I. Go to Ascalon, accept their proposition, and use their influence to promote your agenda.
Okay, we'll do that then.
What will you do?
I still have contacts and old friends in this town. I shall make some inquiries and attempt to learn more of the situation. We need clarity.
Okay, we'll find some clarity.
One day soon, I will have to find the answer to this mystery.
And I shall help you in your research, I promise.
Yeah, let's do it.
For now,
enough
you must go
around
to
the
fireplace and play their game.
Will I see you again at the Pembroke Hospital?
No. You will find me here if you need me. I shall conduct inquiries alone, and we can then share our discoveries.
So first you want to have some sexy? A little sexy before we go?
When will we meet again?
As soon as you meet Lord Redgrave, I suppose. Fear not, my dear. I shall only be a heart's beat away.
I want to thank you for all your support and your help, my lady.
Could you do me a last great favor? And call me Elizabeth?
I should be honored, my lady.
Then it is settled. Finally, some good news.
I'll do that more than that for you, Elizabeth.
How? I appreciate the advice. I had best prepare myself to meet this Lord Redgrave now.
How thrilling to meet the Earl of Bristol in the flesh, so to speak.
I mean, I'd rather
Something
just
tells me
stay
you're
here with you,
then.
Don't get me wrong. The gentlemen of the Ascalon Club are honorable, but their attitude and opinions are somewhat antiquated.
I see.
As long as they deny access to female applicants, I will leave them to their antediluvian considerations as to the natural order of things.
I'm so smart with my antediluvian.
Promise me you'll be careful.
Of course. But why the fear in your voice?
Look at me.
If you were so smart,
I am.
You'd put on your lingerie right now.
Really, look at me, young Ekon.
Now we're getting somewhere. You're getting smarter.
We may be deceptive by nature, but this heart of mine has always told the truth.
Vampires.
Elizabeth.
Do vampires have a beating heart? I feel like they don't.
Go, my friend. But come back to me soon.
Questionable choice right here. I think they just wanted him to feel her boob. Like, yeah, touch a boob. She got too much clothes on, though.
It's locked.
What else is in here?
Dracula?
She been reading Bram Stoker's.
We could perform a play. I'll play Dracula.
The Blood Knight Tragedy. Yeah, that could be the name of our play. It's kind of a bad name, though.
The Blood Knight Tragedy.
Hey, it's me. Always thinking about me, huh? Here, I'll stand here. I'll be your portrait. I'll be your model. That looks good. All right, I'm out of here. See you later. You sure you don't wanna fool around a little? I'm gonna go. Oh, where? Oh, shaking that ass for me? All right. I like that. Oh. The hell? All right. Get out of here.
How dare you interfere with my hunt!
Another vampire! Get out of here. I know how to deal with you. You like that? His health back. I just like stabbing him with my vampire stake. Yeah! Yeah! Weird how the combat does damage in this game. It's not super predictable. Fuck one of you. Oh, come on. How many times I gotta hit your stupid ass? Stop it! I didn't do shit either. Nothing. Don't do nothing! God. You're a little bastard, aren't you? This is some bullshit. Like, look, it's only taking the shield now. Like, I'm better off with the vampire steak. Now the vampire steak's doing a lot of damage. What the hell? Well, on his shield, at least. I will fucking stab you, bitch. Take this. Take it. Love it. I didn't do shit either. Come on. What the fuck? This kind of fucking sucks. We need a level 27. Oh my god, that's nothing. This guy's a fucking dick. Dude, like, what the hell's with his health? Come on! Oh my god, it's not doing shit! That worked. You gotta mix it up! On this guy. For some reason. Take that! Oh, good night, sweet prince. Oh, come on. That didn't do shit. That didn't do shit either. Can't hurt this guy. Oh, for fuck's sake, stop hitting me, you bastard, with your little slidey Iceman move. What do you think you are, X-Men? No, Iceman, bad! He just, like, broke his back. What'd you give me? Fucking $2 and a spring? Worthless, motherfucker! I don't wanna go in here. Oh, an unknown person. Let's go see who it is. You guarding this guy? Hello.
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. Do you need help, sir?
I think I'm fine. But what happened to my jailer? Be careful. He's as vicious as he is strong.
You don't have to worry about him anymore. What happened here?
I am Tadao Kimura.
Tadao!
I was imprisoned by this lunatic for several
That's
days.
That's a cool name. I'm Tadao!
I was going to die here.
It You're not like going to die now, spell it, Mr. Kimura. If you hurry, you should be
Tadao!
Home safely.
It seems that I owe you my life. You have all my gratitude, Dr. Reed, since it is the most precious thing I possess.
Tadao! You're welcome. Let's see, you got healthy. Okay.
Goodbye, Mr. Kimura.
Can't brain suck ya. So, I'll see you later. Investigation succeeded. The heresy of the pure blood. Pure blood! Watch. West End Stable. We have stable conditions around here.
The Ascalon Club. The heart of British vampires.
We made it!
Not quite as subtle as I expected.
Hey!
The equality between men and...
Good evening, miss.
Oh my god, no. Please, Mr. Nope. Vampire, don't kill me.
Oh, she knows.
Please, no. I'm too young to die.
She knows I'm a
I
vampire.
I still have so much to offer this
How
world.
How do you know that?
Wait, no. Why do you think I would...
What?
What?
Don't worry, Dr. Reed. I know you wouldn't harm me.
Huh?
Mother told me you were in this part of town and might drop by.
Mother? Your mother?
My name is Charlotte, sir. Charlotte Ashbury. My mother taught me long ago how to recognize the signs that betray a vampire.
I understand she also taught you how to tease and gently mock innocent young Ekons. It's a pleasure to meet you, Miss Charlotte.
Were you a mean girl? So you're my daughter now? You're my adopted daughter? Because me and
tell me about
your mom are a thing.
What do you want to know?
How did you meet Lady Ashbury?
First, I was an orphan in the institution for girls she manages in the West.
For girls!
When I was 10, she adopted me. And I have lived with her ever since.
Did you know she was a vampire when she picked you?
The correct word is Ekon, Doctor.
Ekon?
And no, I had no idea why my mother only showed up at night.
A little crowbar separation, really.
Though I vampires and Ekons. For a long time before that.
Who are your real
parents?
Who
are your real parents?
Elizabeth Ashbury is my real mother.
Damn!
She raised me and has taken care of me all my life. I have no idea who my progenitors are or were.
Do you live with her?
I still spend a lot of time in my mother's mansion. But I have my own house now. I have a life to live, you see? One day, I'll have my death to face.
What are you doing out here?
You mean, what do I do outside at night since I am a woman?
Yeah, you hoeing?
Let me ask you a question, sir. Would you ask the same question of a man?
Get off that
pole,
daughter.
I ask the same question to everyone who dares to go outside at night, considering the risks.
Well, if you must know, I campaign for the right to vote for all women. Why should I wait to the age of 30 years when men can vote at 21?
How are the locals reacting to your claims?
People here can't wait for a wall to be built to isolate the West End from the rest of town. That's how progressive they are. If this happens, Emily and I will blow it up.
Explosives are very dangerous.
You're fucking terrorists.
And who is this Emily?
She is my best friend, and a suffragette, too.
Yeah, sounds
she
like...
She was supposed to campaign with me tonight, but
kind
hasn't
of
turned up.
Friends you don't
Have you
need.
Any reason to be worried about her?
Recently, Emily started to believe in her. Well, she got interested in...
See, vampires. Go hanging around political people.
I'm afraid she might
wind
be
up being
trouble.
A terrorist.
Let me guess. You spoke to her about us, didn't you? Despite your mother's warning. I think I should try to find your friend.
Oh, that would be top-notch. I can tell you where she might have gone. You have my thanks, Dr. Reed.
Where might she have gone?
And please, don't tell my mother.
New investigation. Emily is missing. You got... Damn, you're worth a lot of money. They know if I kill you, shit's gonna hit the fan. Damn, level 5. Can't even kill you.
Are you a suffragette, then? Oh, you really are Elizabeth's girl. Without a doubt.
All adult women have the right to vote in the US, in New Zealand, and in Australia. But women here can't vote unless they are property owners.
No need to convince me, Miss Charlotte. I have shared your opinion for a long time. Even before I met...
Because property owners vote different.
Really? Oh.
They got more at stake to lose.
I see why my mother appreciates you so much. Too bad there aren't more men like you in the vicinity.
Then just get brainwashed by some people spouting some nonsense.
What do you think about this part of town?
I was raised here, and I suppose it feels like home. You grew up in this part of town too, did you not?
Yep.
Is there something that's bothering you?
Too much selfishness and individualism for my taste. Even when there was no epidemic.
Even if that's
well, you're gonna hate
true.
The future.
May I remind you that many charitable institutions are financed by the selfish and filthy rich?
I suppose you're right. But society must reform and renew itself, or we are all done for.
Must it?
Yes, I was born a few streets away.
A small world, is it not? Did you ever imagine that my mother was your neighbor all that time? That you could have met her in a dark alley at night?
You won't.
Yeah, we could have ruined the relationship already.
We both know Lady Ashbury never hunts or attacks prey at random.
Come on, Doctor. Don't tell me you never
we
thought about that possibility.
We could have built up so much resentment by now.
Have fangs on your neck. Oh, are you blushing, Dr. Reed?
No. I don't have
what
blood
exactly
to blush.
What exactly has your mother told you about me?
Your name and profession, obviously. And the mystery about your makeup.
My makeup?
I'm sorry to hear about what happened to your sister, sir. Mother says it was not your fault.
Does it not scare you to know what I am? What your mother is?
Why should it?
I'll snap your neck.
My mother is the most compassionate woman. Must I be wary of her, Dr. Reed? Or you?
Maybe. Maybe.
Of course not. You have nothing to fear from me or your mother.
Good to know. And don't worry, my mother told me everything I need to know about vampire tricks, their nature as well as features.
Your mother is not like any other vampire I've met.
I believe she thinks the same about you, Dr. Reed.
Oh, likewise. Why did
Lady Ashbury choose you to become her daughter?
No, I don't. Each time I ask her that question, she smiles and says it's precisely because I dare to ask such questions.
Do you ever regret that she chose you?
Of course not. Though I often wonder if she adopted others before me.
I'm sure.
So, where are they buried? How was it for them to pass through life with a never-aging mother?
Just the way it is for you, I would imagine.
Goodbye, Charlotte. Give my best regards to your mother when you see her.
She's been quite...
Say hello to your mother for me! Hey, donkey!
I suspect you may see her before me.
Hey, donkey! Ashkelon Club! We made it! Let me the fuck in! I've been trying to get here all fucking day. Yeah, I know where I'm at. I presume. Let me
the Ascalon Club only summons or ostracizes. What is your business tonight?
I'm here to teabag everyone.
I received an invitation. I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed.
Welcome to the Ascalon Club, then, Dr. Reed. Please proceed.
The king is
Lord
back!
Lord Redgrave is waiting on you upstairs.
What
there has been quite a battle here.
Got some nom-nom?
I'm sure the money. Ascalon Club has the money to replace the furniture.
Yeah, it looks like a fucking dump in here, guys. Holy shit. At least they left the piano alone.
It's locked.
Oh, come on. Let's go upstairs. what's this? A good dagger? It's hard to find good weapons in this game. Here's where the good dagger is. Blood absorption. I don't use those. I like the steak, so I can bite people. Suck your blood. Give me your blood. Loot. Booty. What's going on in here? Diddy party?
Good evening.
Hey, guys. Anybody got some cocaine? I hear y'all are really big into opium. I brought some codeine.
My good friends, if I may have your attention.
Codeine.
Behold our visitor, the good Dr. Reed. Newborn of blood so pure and strong that even my friend Fergal Bansha was no match for him.
Fergal Bansha! Yeah, your friend was a pussy.
Come
big
forward,
old pussy.
Young Echo, for we have so much to discuss.
Yeah, I need to figure you out, buddy.
Welcome to the Ascalon Club, Dr. Reed. I am Lord Redgrave, Earl of Bristol, and chairman of this exclusive association.
Lord Redgrave.
How prestigious.
At last we meet. I've been eager to make your acquaintance. I've heard some astounding things about you.
Well, what do you
Please
expect?
Accept my condolences for your loss, Dr. Reed.
Thank you, my lord. Lady Ashbury expressed your wish to meet me.
Yes. The lady has always been a useful acquaintance, though not always reliable. Is she a good friend of yours?
She sucks my cock. That's not an option on here. Yeah, we're friends.
She's a close friend.
She's just a friend of mine.
And I'm honored that she feels the same about me.
I don't really want to tell him that.
The centuries have taught me never to trust a woman completely, especially if she is immortal. Too prone to emotions, if you ask me. Too fickle when it comes to important decisions.
My lord,
yes.
Do not expect me to speak ill of Lady Ashbury.
Of course not, and I praise your loyalty. Would you offer the same fidelity to the Empire?
What do you mean?
The Empire?
I speak of the Scowl Plague that threatens London and the country.
But what of the rebellion?
You have been on the front line in the East End. But the time has come to open up a second front here.
The epidemic has escaped the quarantine. You have new cases of the outbreak.
We don't know for certain. But we cannot allow the disease to threaten the prominent heads of Great Britain.
Why not? Think they're special?
Why are you suddenly so friendly? The last time I met one of yours, he tried to kill me.
Are you referring to Fergal? He was the most useful of servants, but he was just a servant. You, on the other hand, Doctor, proved yourself much more worthy.
You want me to find possible sources of the outbreak in the West End. Is that it?
Ah, straight to the point, like all eager newborns. We shall have time to talk about all this, Dr. Reed. But first, I should like to get to know you better.
Talk? Is that the only reason you asked me here?
Well, no. I also wanted to meet the intriguing
Because I got a fireplace at home to talk to.
Progeny of his sister.
With a lady.
You have not learned the name of your maker, am I correct?
No, I do not know my maker, okay?
No, I haven't.
Have no embarrassment, Dr. Reed. We all make mistakes. But whatever your lineage, you are definitely Ascalon material.
What do you mean?
I would like you to become a member of the Ascalon Club.
Me?
And serve me as such.
Serve you? I mean,
I agree to join the
if you
club.
Can't beat
this
them,
is good news.
Join them.
Good news indeed in these
I'm gonna need
times.
Some help.
Let's inform
fighting off all these damn zombies.
Proceed with your initiation.
And I'm tired of
My
having
initiation.
Samurai sword men
Fear
come
not.
After me.
Nothing fancy nor dangerous.
That I can't hurt.
It is just that we, the members of Ascalon, believe that tradition and custom are the backbone of this country. My fellow members, dear friends, please gather and welcome this Ekon as one of our own.
Is he worthy?
Fuckload of vampires.
Is his blood pure?
Well, speak, Dr. Reed.
Mudblood.
In front of the most sacred blood. The blood of our beloved William Marshall.
I'm speak just a baby.
Now.
How am I supposed to know?
Will you serve and
I'm
protect
just a little
Ekon
baby.
Did?
I don't know shit about vampires, that's why I'm talking to you guys.
Yes. I will.
Then, young Ekon, it
yeah,
is time
just a baby.
To testify with your blood.
Oh god. What does that mean?
It is time to sign the Book of Allegiance.
Uh-oh. Is this like the contract?
I know it's awfully gothic and a tad pedantic.
Is this the contract to Satan?
England's traditions are the backbone of our nation.
I'm already damned. It's all right. I'm gonna hold my fingers crossed while I sign it. That means it don't count. Yeah, I'm signing your little bookie. And I'll judge you and decide if I want to eliminate you, because I will be the last vampire! But I gotta keep my food.
Welcome to the Ascalon Club, Doctor.
I gotta keep the population healthy.
Take
so I got something to eat.
Take your place among the bearers of the lance.
Get rid of y'all.
One of us.
One of us. One of us.
That went well, did it not? It is always useful to bolster the troops' morale, especially before a difficult battle.
You have the makings of a general, my lord.
I was, though very long ago. Well, not quite a general, but a proud defender of the crown.
So why did you really want to meet
me? That's not
straight to the point
like
again, young Ekon.
Just to
all
be
right,
clear.
Let's talk, you and I, Lance.
I was the defender of the crown,
according to my spies. You have worked with Dr. Edgar Swansea on the epidemic, and your findings were quite alarming.
Do you know Edgar Swansea?
Not personally, but I've been told he has some sort of immortal fetish and is a good friend of yours.
Does it bother you that I consider him my good friend?
As long as you reveal nothing of the club's inner workings, why should I forbid you engaging in conversation with the good Dr. Swansea?
Yes, I'm convinced the recent invasion of frenzied scowls in London is directly linked to the epidemic. This is not the Spanish flu, but something else.
I would be glad to hear more of your discoveries, Dr. Reed, but for now, my main concern is the security of London's inhabitants, both mortal and immortal.
What do you mean?
Alarmed by the epidemic, the Guard of Priwen has started a war against us British vampires. To appease the situation, we must eradicate the Skulls.
Must we? I mean, they seemed like they could go.
I have met peaceful and wise Skulls. To exterminate
them means
we are no better than vampire hunters.
Skulls are hideous, shameful creatures that give all Ekon a bad name.
He's not wrong.
What do you want me to do?
I want you to investigate the city thoroughly. I have reason to fear there are cases of contagion in this part of town. Our absolute priority is to find and cleanse them.
And how would you like me to proceed?
By all means necessary, Dr.
Reed. This is like Star Wars.
You are now a member of the Ascalon Club, and you have carte blanche. Interrogate the locals, follow all the leads you find, and get results.
This is like I'm Darth Vader.
Eliminate the rebellion at once!
Should I eat this guy? Chapter 4! Family Portraits, next time! On Vampyr!